Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'll be sharing with you one of the recipes that I desperately wanted to make. When I'm genuinely asked what type of bread you like, I love baguette. I like these hard crusty bread with a very soft inside. So I was trying to make some bread and I decided why not add chocolate. And previously I have made a couple of these recipes which turned out to be very good. But it was quite on the expensive side because I used Nutella and all these baking chocolates. But then I decided, why don't I try and make it with something I can find in each and every store. So I went and I bought some 5 stars and I tried it. Guess what? The 5-star was not the 5-star of my recipe. It was not as expected, but it's a fun video for you to watch. Take a look.
To start with, I've activated some yeast in some sugar water. And in a separate bowl, I'm taking some all-purpose flour. And I'm mixing the activated yeast well into it. Now I'm slowly going to start adding a little bit of lukewarm water. Make sure the water is not very hot and not very cold. So once the dough is ready, you have to let it rest for at least 1 to 2 hours. Once your dough is ready, you have to deflate the dough once again. That means you have to punch back all the air. You can use some flour to do this because the dough turns out to be very sticky once it has risen. After kneading the dough well, you have to let it rest again for half an hour. So after the set time, you will realize that the dough has risen quite a bit. Now you just have to divide the dough into small portions. I personally prefer to go with a smaller size because since I'm making it in a pan and not in an oven, it becomes much more easier to work with it. So here I'm taking 5-star, which is one of my favorite chocolates. I previously did the same recipe with some Nutella and that turned out to be really delicious. The reason I'm selecting 5-star is because it is readily available in any small shop and it's just 5 rupees for one piece, so you will not be spending a huge amount just to make this small recipe. Nutella otherwise comes in a jar and the jar is almost 350 to 400 rupees. So once you've packed your 5-star into the dough, make sure all the sides are covered really well because you do not want the chocolate to be oozing out before cooking. So you're going to repeat the process and make all tiny buns. You can shape it the way you want to, but I like the half moon shaped. Dust your dough with some flour and let it rest for 15 to 20 minutes. Once the resting process is over, you will realize that it has fluffed up a little bit. Now you want to use a heavy bottomed pan. Place your bun directly in the heated pan and then you want to cover it with some oval or circular shape so that the heat rotation is possible. So our goal or target here is not to look for a very soft bun, but you want this crusty outer cover. So once you attain that in one side, you flip it and do the same for the other side. Maintaining a constant low temperature, this should take you approximately 10 to 12 minutes on each side. So once both the sides have become nice and crusty, what you want to do is you want to switch off the flame and you want to let it rest in that residual heat till the pan is completely cool to touch. So there you go guys, your chocolate stuffed bun is ready. You can serve it the way you like it, but I personally prefer mine to be served with an extra glass of really cold milk. So let's tear it up and see. I'm actually very happy with how the bread has turned out to be. It's nice and crusty on the outside and it's really soft at the center. Frankly, I'm quite impressed with the tiny air bubbles in the bread. But I'm not very impressed with 5-star because I expected a thicker consistency considering how chewy 5-star is. But this turned out to be very thin and flowy. So if you ask me, I would rather prefer Nutella over 5-star. I've seen a lot of people prepare the same recipe with some custard, so I think that will go well too. And if you are looking out just to make a bread, you can just skip the chocolate part and repeat the same process. I think this bread would actually go really well if there is meat stuffed inside, and you could make it into a nice Vietnamese banh mi sandwiches. So that's it for today, guys. If you find better recipes with chocolate stuffed in, share the link down in the comment section below. And when you're here, don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel. So keep living, keep eating and definitely keep feeding. Until next time, goodbye.